In this video, we'll get the ALFA AWUS036ACH wireless adapter, this one right here. We'll get this adapter to work with Kali 2019.3 running in VirtualBox. Sometimes you want to do a wireless penetration test, and this is one of the adapters you can put in monitoring mode, but sometimes it doesn't quite work well in different versions of Kali or in VirtualBox, and that's the obstacle we'll overcome in this video. I'm Christian Espinoza with Alpine Security. Thanks for watching. So the first thing we'll do is in VirtualBox Manager, you need to change the USB driver. If you go to Settings here, and then to USB, you need to change this to be the USB 1.1 controller. For some reason, if you try to use 2.0 or 3.0 with this Alpha USB NIC, it won't work properly. So we'll select 1.1 there. I'll go ahead and start the VM. And there's a few other things we have to do once the virtual machine starts up. Those are basically installing the driver and doing a test. All right. It looks like Kali has finally booted up. I'm going to log on here. And normally, if you just try to plug the Alpha USB adapter in, which I'll do right here, it isn't recognized by Kali, even though we've changed the USB controller to 1.1. So I'll go ahead and plug that in. We'll just see what it looks like before we set this up properly. So it's plugged in, and the light is flashing. I don't know if you can see the blue light there flashing. So right now, the Windows 10 host has control of this adapter. I'm going to switch it to Kali. So I'm going to go down here to the USB icon. It shows up as a Realtek 802.n NIC. That's actually what this Alpha NIC is. So I'm going to select that. And you'll see it looks like it's selected here. I'm going to go to Command Prompt. I do ifconfig. So if this is working, we should see a WLAN 0, which is the wireless LAN 0, and we do not see that, even though this USB NIC is being controlled by the Kali virtual machine. Sometimes it takes a few seconds, so I'll go ahead and do ifconfig a few times here, and let's just verify that the virtual machine does in fact have control over this. It is checked there, so it does, and it's not being seen here. So what we have to do to make this NIC be seen, make the Alpha AWUS036ACH NIC be seen, is add the proper drivers. And that's what I'm going to walk you through. And I will put these drivers beneath the video as well and the steps here. So I've got them saved in a text file. So here's the driver we're going to install. So I'm going to copy this, paste it over here. And this is really the gist of it. Once this is done installing, we should be able to see WLAN 0 if it's working properly. Looks like it's about 60% done. It may take a few minutes to install. Once this is completed, I should be able to do an ifconfig and see WLAN 0. The next video will go over how to use Wi-Fi with this Alpha adapter to capture the four-way WPA2 handshake. And then a video after that, we'll use Hashcat to crack the four-way handshake to reveal the passphrase. It looks like the driver has finished installing. So let's go to our settings over here. It looks like it is still attached to Kali. Let's do an ifconfig now. And now we see WLAN 0. So this adapter, the other way to tell, I don't know if you can see it in the video, but the blue light is flashing right now. So we did two things basically to make this Alpha AWUS036ACH adapter work with Kali. We changed the USB controller to 1.1, and we installed the Realtek RTL88XXAU-DKMS driver. Now that it's working, in the next video, we will use Wi-Fi to capture a four-way WPA2 handshake and then later on crack that handshake. I hope you found this video useful. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and I'll talk to you later on.